So we always try and do a few things in our famous little tag cabinets.
Yes.
Instead of giving out business cards this year, what we're giving out is our IQ labels with some of our salespeople's information printed on it.
Really?
And it's encoded with that kind of stuff. So it's great that they can go here and use that as a sample to give out to customers. So IQ continues to be one of our fastest growing passive product lines. The ability to print these through a normal Zebra printer and put them on any metal asset, pipes, cabinets, is just a fantastic innovation in the marketplace. This is a line that will continue to expand with new sizes and formats. So it's one of our feature products we continue to talk about everywhere.
So they can get the information and use the tag as a demo.
Yeah.
That is really cool. You can take it away and use it back at home and see how it works for you.
Yeah,
wow.
Exactly.
Great idea.
And now, is our cabinet unlocked, Mo? Mm-hmm. We can pull some things out. We put a few little, it's impossible to show all the projects we're doing because we're becoming more and more pervasive in a lot of different applications, but some applications are pretty cool. So let me show you the Motorola radio knob.
Yeah, this one's fun.
Yeah, Motorola announced at their partner conference just last month this new innovation that we've done with them. We're showing it here exposed, but you can see one of our fit tags embedded into the Motorola radio knob. Under normal conditions, it'll be completely covered up, so you wouldn't see it, but of course we want you to see it for this particular purpose. Motorola is the market leader in the world, worldwide radio market, going out to all sorts of government, security, emergency responders everywhere. And one of their issues, of course, is to inventory their radios. They rent many of them out on service contracts to be able to understand the life of those radios, when they need to be replaced, you know, service conditions, things like that. They worked with us to create an RFID type program that would allow them to scan these radios, and we talked about all sorts of things, putting labels in the radio. We came up with the idea of using our little ceramic tags in the knob, and they really liked that idea because it's an attachment that can be added to any radio. You can RFID enable it by just replacing the knob with an RFID knob.
You don't have to get new radios. If you put it in the radio, you have to get all new radios.
This allows us to retrofit the entire fleet around the world right now, as well as go forward on all the radios. So it was a major program they announced at their partner conference last month. It's a service that some of their value-add resellers can resell in terms of monitoring and reconditioning radios, and it's all enabled by the Omni-ID RFID tag.
Well, that is amazing.
So we're showing that one. How about the ballast bolt? That's another cool one.
That is great.
We do a lot of these with different companies, but this one in particular from Balif is their new smart bolt. Yep. So here again, much like that radio knob, except in this case we've got a metal structure around it, we put one of our fit tags inside of that and overmolded it.
Okay.
And they can now sell that as a smart bolt that goes into engine blocks, pumps, filter stations, and you're able then to read all sorts of configuration data. When was the engine last serviced? What's its useful life? When does it need to come back? What's its parameters? There's some cases where this goes on a tool. And a great thing about tools are tools experience drift. So when you put a tool into a machine, some of them are not exactly like the tool that was before. We can encode all the drift information on here, so the CNC machine can automatically read it, change its settings, and then go right into production without any manual intervention. So there's a lot of benefit
that
to smart bolts like this.
Tiny too.
Yep. It's a great example of where RFID can play in a lot of different places. And this is a fantastic program that we hope to expand with a lot of other applications.
Weapons?
Calling it the weapons tag, but this is the EXO 700. There's some really cool things about the EXO 700. As you can see by that format, it's actually EXO because it's got the rubber coating around, as you know how we name our families. But inside, you have what we would call a fit tag, a ceramic tag. And the reason why the rubber coating doesn't go all the way around is this tag's meant to mount directly on the metal for maximum read performance. We can get up to 7 meters of read range with this under the right conditions on this small tag. Very important.
That's amazing.
It is. But it was important, especially for our core customer. This was made for the United States Marine Corps, and it's going on all of their weapons, all their different guns and gun kits. We've already implemented quite a few of them, and they're already rolling out to the field, and many, many more are coming every month as we keep tagging all the different weapons cases.
Wow.
So, of course, the use case here is that you're trying to understand your inventory of weapons, but also when they go out to the field, you want to kit them. A weapon's no good by itself.
Right.
You need an ammo box, you often need optics, you need a tripod, and all those things need to be scanned and put together and then sent downrange, so that when the soldier gets it, he's got everything he needs to do his job. This tag is enabling the Marine Corps to do that. What's really cool about it, from our perspective, it's really cool. ceramic has been used by different RFID companies, not a lot, but a few RFID companies are starting to realize the benefit of making UHF ceramic RFID tags like we do. But it's very hard to work with. It has a very high Q, a very sharp peak in its characteristics. That makes it very difficult to spread out over a wide spectrum like other materials that are a little bit easier to work with. So no one's ever tried to do a dual band ceramic. And when I say dual band, you know that there's two main global frequencies, around 860 and around 930. You have to usually group your curve of response around those two frequencies. On some materials, you can just kind of flatten your curve, sacrifice your read range, and let it spread out in kind of a lower arc and cover both frequencies. That's how many of our competitors do it.
Right.
If you get a little more complex, you can build a dual node to it so you can cover both frequencies.
Okay.
In ceramic, you can't do a dual node. And it's hard, you can't, the Q is so sharp, you can't flatten it to make it go. So you have to do things that are a lot fancier than that. And I can't tell you what we did because I'd have to kill you. to create a dual mode in ceramic is really, really difficult. We don't believe anyone ever has done it before. And we're the first company in the world to have done that. So this is a truly global tag that operates on both frequencies in small ceramic package.
With the right read range that you had before with doing one band or the other.
That's right.
The same kind of read range.
On both bands. And that is tough sauce.
Right.
But we got it and it's fantastic and we're going to do a lot of government business with this in particular, but there's many other applications that we're talking to and working with.
Well, how do you put that on? How are they putting it on the machine guns? Just wondering, are they using epoxy for that?
Yep, they are.
Oh, gotcha.
So
they,
this peel and stick allows you just to center and get it in the right spot. So there's a place on the receiver we want to put it down. So you peel and stick. But what they're doing is then they go around it, even before they peel and stack actually, they go and put a bead of epoxy around and then they put it down with this metal welder as we've talked about before on pipes. So we worked with them again to, it's our favorite tool. These things are great. When you put it on, it's never gonna go anywhere. And you epoxy around like this, you peel and you stick and it's there forever.
Great. Okay, so it's not coming off if you're throwing the gun, like not throwing the gun, but you know,
you'll
putting it in with a bunch of guns.
It's there forever, but it's not just guns. I mean, another great example of an application we're working with this on is what they call the ULDs, or the containers that go in the bellies of planes. Those big metal containers that have your luggage, they're shipped all over the world, so they have to be dual frequency.
Mm-hmm.
They have a lot of rugged banging and clanging going around, and they can't alter them very much. You can't have a big tag on it.
Right.
You have to fit in a little recess. So this can go right in there, be read as it goes in and out of the belly of the plane, and operate around the world, you know, real easy. Same idea.
Wow.
Epoxy weld it down and it's there forever. Life of the container.
Awesome global tag.
Yeah. It's really a fantastic global tag. So these are some of the innovations. Oh, maybe our BAP tag
we
should show.
Yeah, I thought that would be good.
So. Another category for us again. So we've expanded our power family. We've already showed you our active tag, which was our first power product. This is our BAP tag, which is also in the power family. It's our power 50 tag. It's in the same case as we've had our previous passive tag, our Max HD, so you recognize it looks the same.
Yes, it does look like the Max HD tag.
The difference is now we put a little coin cell battery inside of here. That allows you to amplify the signal, so it's a battery assisted passive. Battery assisted passive has been around for a long time. Different people have tried it. There's some applications it's definitely not good for. There's some that it's good for.
Right.
And we had a core customer come to us and say, could you make a battery assisted passive? And we said, you know what? We're already making active tags. We can do that.
Right.
And so this is our first battery assisted passive. You can get tremendous read range out of this, easily 100, 150 feet in a construction site or a place where you need that range. And of course, tremendous battery life because it's only assisting lightly. So a 5-year battery life. 150 feet read range is really doable.
So if you have the regular Max HD, what's the difference in the read range there? Like how many are you getting with passive and then when you upgrade to the
About
BAP?
Two and a half. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it'll make it 2.5-3 times more powerful by adding the battery assist.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's perfect for the industrial places where you're not up and close with what you're tagging and what you're reading.
Exactly.
That
it's kind
amazing.
Of a halfway in between where the active tag, if you hand that to me, Mo, has of course a full battery transmission. It's on 433.
Mm-hmm.
You know, here we're getting 150, 200 meters, in some cases 400 meters in the right environments with the active tag fully powered. Battery assisted passive can use a standard passive reader and get you kind of in between there, you know, half of that 100, 150 feet versus passive. So it's a full range if we had all three. In fact, there's a passive. There's your passive tag.
I'll get my passive.
So that gives you close range, lets you get out to, you know, 10 meters maybe, depending on the size of tag you have. Then you get one out here that's going to get you in that 35 to 50 meter range.
Right.
And then you get one out here that's going to get you up to 100 meters.
Wow.
And so depending on what asset you're tagging, what your environment is, you get to choose. And Omni-ID allows you to choose within that same family with one source of responsibility the right tag for your application.
Wow. Okay, great. And y'all sell all of them, which is awesome.
We sell them all. And all through the Atlas RFID store.
Yes,
you can get any of them.
Of course. We love selling them too. Those Max HDs go pretty fast.
Yeah. So,
Do you want to talk about that passive at all?
Sure.
That's a new fun one.
It's not even officially launched, is it? Is this a show exclusive for the Atlas RFID?
I guess it would be.
Yay!
Okay. Show exclusive.
Oh my goodness.
We haven't put the launch materials out to this yet, so it's not on the website, and I don't think it's on the store yet.
No,
but this is
a pretty big secret, and we are learning about it firsthand at the Omni-ID booth. So tell us what this is.
This is the 800P.
Okay.
So it's made to be an off-metal tag, but it is plastic and flexible with mounting holes on the side.
Okay.
Has tremendous read range, 8 meters, with a very small package like this. And this allows us to have a really weatherproof and printable surface, which we've been using in its particular application. I can talk about the application.
We can talk about it, yeah. It's an adaptation on this one.
Right.
Okay.
So that's the kind of format.
Yeah, versus this kind of a format. Now we have a format that's much more rugged and able to put down. What's interesting about this was done as part of a deal with the government in Bangladesh over in India.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And it's going on the back of rickshaws. If you've ever seen those rickshaws going around the streets.
I think so, yeah. I think I know what you're talking about.
So the difficulty is, of course, windshield tagging is common for toll booths and things like that.
Right.
But what do you do when you don't have a windshield?
Right.
Like a rickshaw.
Yeah, they don't.
They don't have a windshield. And so we said, how can we solve that problem? And we created something of a license plate. And this gets encoded, of course, with a visible license number of the rickshaw driver.
Wow.
So that it ensures that they've paid their taxes, that they're an authorized rickshaw driver, like a cab fob. And this goes right on the back of the rickshaw, like a little license plate, and gets read at different read stations to prove that they're authentic.
Really?
Yes.
That's like our tag system for our cars.
You know,
like having to have it per year and making sure that you're up to date.
Exactly.
That is awesome.
Allows them to do their different tools and taxes. So yeah, it's a fantastic little product. We think we'll sell it not just at rickshaws in Bangladesh, but rickshaws in Bangladesh have been a fantastic application for it. So that's the 800P, not even launched yet.
And RTIs.
Wow. Yes, of course. Yeah, we also use the same thing for plastic RTIs. It can be used for material handling and things like that. But I just think it's a fun story.
Well, pretty exclusive. I'm so glad we got to learn about it.
Okay. One last piece. This is our ProView starter kit. So we've already mentioned about the active tag and the visual tag programs and how key those are. For us, it's our highest growth area, and it's a real strategic focus for us. To enable our partners, we created a simple kit that allows them to get on board quickly.
Okay.
And this ProView starter kit comes in two flavors, as you can see on the end. You can order it as a visual starter kit or as a power. So it's either view or power as a kit.
All right.
It's the same software, the same API, the same gateways as we mentioned.
Okay.
It's just that some customers are coming for the active and some are for the visual.
Right.
And some want both, and we mix the kit, right?
Mix it together.
This is the tiny little gateway that actually controls the system. Really simple to implement.
Wow.
And in some cases, we will make that little card available to slip into the slot of a mobile computer for some particular customers like you might know. With that, you can talk to the active tag just as we showed in the coolest demo.
Right.
Or you can speak directly to a visual tag that'll come in the kit. So you'll have one of these in the kit as well, so you can go ahead and exercise it. The Tag Lab software that you saw on the tablet is in a little flash drive in this box.
Wow, okay.
So you've got all the documentation, a quick start guide, some frequently asked questions, as well as the software API, a little .NET library to be able to talk directly to these things. And in order to be able to read them and trigger them, we put a little ThingMagic Wedge RFID reader in.
Which we love. Love our ThingMagic readers.
They're fantastic.
Right?
Yeah, we love them too. And they fit great in the kit. So that allows you to wake up the tags, trigger the tags, read the tags, change the parameter settings. Because one of the things I don't think we talked about enough is that the active tag here also has a passive tag in it. That not only allows you to read it through a passive infrastructure, but you can configure the tag, change its beacon rate, change its extended beacon parameters, write user data to it to set it up for a project. All that can be done through your fancy little reader.
Awesome.
So this kit has everything a developer needs to get started on the ProView system. All their cables are here, all the little pieces and antennas that they need to get it going. And it's all in one simple kit available at the Atlas RFID store.
Yes, it is. Yeah. And we're excited about that because we've never had a kit like that. Well, we've never had any active kit, but this is the first one on our website that actually has everything you need to get started. And of course, when you get started and realize which one works best for you, either the visual, the active, or the passive part of the active, then you can buy more and get started and just grow. I mean,
absolutely.
It's amazing.
Yep. So there we are. Is that enough new things for you?
That is. Thank you so much, Ed, for everything. We really appreciate it. I hope you have a great end to RFID Journal Live, and we appreciate walking us around the booth.
Cheer for us for best in show and coolest demo.
We
hope we win them both.
All right. Thank you.